गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास।
चैप्टर 5 ऑर्गेनाइजिंग। नाउ फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डेलीगेशन, मीन्स व्हाट आर द अथॉरिटीज ऑफ डेलीगेशन, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द अथॉरिटी एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, व्हाट आर द प्रोसेस एंड स्टेप्स और एलिमेंट्स ऑफ डेलीगेशन। Now delegation of authority. So as for fuel, division of work permits reduction in the number of objects to which attention and effort must be directed and has been recognized as the best means of making use of individuals and a group of people. Okay, here is different delegations, means formal delegation and informal delegation. So what is formal delegation? Means when authority is delegated as per the organizational structure, such delegation is effective because it leaves no option to the subordinates but to obey the command of the superior. Now informal delegation, it takes place when an individual or group agree to work under the direction of a informal leader. Informal leader means what? Not directed leader. Now the elements of delegation. Elements of delegation and the process of delegation both are same. There are three main elements, that is responsibility, authority and accountability. Responsibility means what? The work assigned to an individual, means the work is given to an individual person. Now authority means to take power, to take decision, to carry on the responsibility. Every employee need to have some authority. It must be equal to responsibility. Okay, now lastly accountability, being answerable for incomplete task. Final output, it cannot be passed or delegated. It deal with regular feedback. Difference between authority and responsibility. We can differentiate between these two on the basis of meaning, afterwards source of origin, thirdly direction of flow, and lastly purpose. Means what are the purpose for authority and what are the purpose for responsibility. So here are the meaning of authority. Means the power or right of a superior to order to others. This is authority. And responsibility, it is an obligation to perform the assigned duty or order. Means this is the responsibility which we have to do. Means now source of origin, it emerged from a formal position in the organization. At the same time in responsibility, it emerged from superior subordinate to relationship. Thirdly, direction of flow, it flowed downwards, but responsibility flow upwards. Authority from top to bottom, here responsibility bottom to the top level. Okay, and lastly, what are the purpose of authority and responsibility? Come to authority, its purpose is to make decision and take the decision executive. Now responsibility, its purpose is to execute the duties assigned by the superior. Principle of delegation of authority. Here are the three different or three important principle of delegation of authority is, first one is principle of result expected. Secondly, principle of party of authority and responsibility. And lastly, principle of absolute responsibility. In this slide, all these three points are clearly defined. You just have to go through it. Problem in delegation or the barriers in delegation. Means what are the problems? What are the brackets? So as per the manager, the problem is reluctant to delegate. Disorganization prevent planning work in advance. Subordinate success threaten superior advancement. Lack of trust in the subordinate to do well. Now the second point, to the subordinate, या रिलिक्वेंट टू द एक्सेप्ट डेलीगेशन फॉर फियर ऑफ फेलियर. नेक्स्ट वन, परसीव नो वर्ड्स फॉर एक्सेप्टिंग एडिशनल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. एंड द थर्ड पॉइंट, प्रिफर टू अवॉइड एनी रिस्क एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द थर्ड पॉइंट विच इज लेस इंपॉर्टेंट बट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. वी हैव डिस्कस ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ मैनेजर और ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ सबऑर्डिनेट. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. ड्यू टू वीकनेस इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन स्ट्रक्चर द प्रोसेस ऑफ डेलीगेशन बी हैम्पर्ड. सम ऑफ द वीकनेस आर लैक ऑफ यूनिटी ऑफ कमांड. Due to the lack of unity, now inadequate planning because no proper planning, absence of effective control techniques, non-availability of contempt manager, and lastly, environment of internal distrust. So these are the problems in delegation. These are the barriers. Delegation or decentralization. So we all know what is delegation. We have discussed in the first three slide. Now, decentralization, I am going to explain you in my next class. We will come to know what is centralization and what is decentralization. Comparison between delegation and decentralization means what are the similarities, what are the comparison between the delegation and decentralization. So I am going to give you the different point or different basis of points, means on the basis of meaning, that is for the first one. Now next one, nature, involvement, compensation. Fifth one is control, sex, process, dependence, freedom of action. So these are the different basis. On the basis of that, you have to compare that between delegation and decentralization. Here is the summary for this class, which you have to go through it and follow the PDF which I have given you for the homework, and you have to submit it by tomorrow.